Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and we are back playing a little bit more Iron Fish. This video has been about an hour in the making, and I'm going to explain why. Basically, as you can see, last video we were at the sundial, right? We had this goal to fix the sundial, and I didn't really have a clue how. My objective marker actually points over there to the Pomeranz, the boat we were at last episode and the episode before. And if we go into our inventory, we have this thing, an ancient artifact. That's what we got from that first chest, the one where we got attacked by a mermaid thing, right? Right. That's a shark. Unfortunately, the objective marker doesn't actually point you to your objective. It points you to the Pomeranz, and then the objective is nearby. There's something I missed near here, and thankfully, there's one other person on YouTube who's actually playing this game. Literally one other person is in German, but I managed to see what's going on. There's a crate around here. I think it's that one right there. And I believe inside that crate is an underwater adhesive. Now we use that underwater adhesive to attach the artifact bit, the stick, to the sundial. The sundial had a broken thing in the middle. We attached the artifact to the top of it using this underwater adhesive. I would never have found that. I was looking around that ship for about half an hour trying to find the bloody whatever I needed, because the game doesn't tell you what you need. So, it's not this one. I know it's a crate around here, though. I don't know that. I think that. I'm confident there's a crate around here that contains underwater adhesive. That one. That one right there. That's the golden ticket crate, right? Look at it open and just like, come on, come on, BestInSlot. Come and look inside me. I'm like, you cheeky little blighter. That's very British. Cheeky little blighter. Well, I think this is the one. I've got faith. I'm watching you, shark boy. Something lit up there.
Oh my god.
Cerys, what did
you see? Boob!
I think I've found the crew of the Pomeranz. What's left of them?
Get out of the way. It's there! I knew it!
There's some adhesive here, Marshal.
Those ships usually carry fast-drying adhesives to make repairs in case of hull breaches.
What the hell did I just get?
Why not hang on to it, in case it comes in handy?
Well, maybe it will come in handy.
What's sticking to it?
Aquajet light upgrade? Did she just make a pun? Oh god, I love this woman. Right. So, we can actually head back and now actually fix the sundial. I'm sure the idea is you're meant to explore a little bit, but there is no indication whatsoever that you're meant to go, that you should look in any of these. The objective marker points to the boat, so I went to the boat. That's all there is to it. I think there needs to be something. What they need to do is, when you go to the sundial, if you don't have it, say, hey, maybe you need an adhesive. Why don't you go check around the Pomeranz, or check the crates around, just something, just a tiny hint at least, so I don't spend an hour looking in the boat and rely on a German YouTuber to find it. But maybe that's just me and being lazy and not exploring enough, so God only knows. I do want to say that somebody's been smashing up my sub royally. What? When did this happen? The bugs that I found in the first episodes in particular that made me do the first episode a few times, that's been hot-fixed already. A couple of the other problems I know have been hot-fixed as well. The devs are really good at getting on it and getting stuff done. So, a lot of the negative reviews have kind of been bug-related. And it's not a super polished game at the end of the day. It's a very small dev team. I think it's 3 people or something. But, you know, a little bug here and there, it's fine. As long as they're quick to fix it and get on board, I'm playing it so you can wait until it's fully hotfixed. I can play through the whole game, find every bug, and then once it's all been fixed, you guys can all buy the game and play it. And that makes sense. That's so clever. Anyways, we can now go fix the sundial. So long getting to this point. So long. First time I recorded it, I was sitting at the sundial. We started off at the sundial, I was going to go fix it, didn't really know how, and the objective marker points to the Pomeranz. So I thought, right, I'll go back to the Pomeranz. Couldn't find anything at the Pomeranz at the green marker, so I thought, okay, we'll go back to the sundial, see if there's something I missed there. Maybe the green marker's just in the wrong place. Went back to the sundial, but the problem was I couldn't go back to the sundial because I couldn't find my way back to the sundial, so I had to load up the video that I'd thankfully recorded, reverse the direction. I went north, northeast, I think, to get to the sundial. So I went southwest to get to the Pomeranz, so I had to go northeast to get back to the sundial. Managed to find my way back over here. Then I realized, oh no, I need something else as well. So I had to go back to the Pomeranz. It's been a long day. Basically. Oh, but we're here. I do love this game, quirks and all. It's a bit of a mess, but I do really like it. It's creepy as balls. This is still not even deep water. I can see. Well, you can't hear, but yeah, look at it. Look how shiny it is. That's because we're so close to the surface. But there's something deeper than this. It gets a whole lot deeper.
What's your oxygen levels, Cerys? I wouldn't wander too far from your sub without the aquajet. That's what it's there for.
I've gone like a yard. He's a very overprotective man, this man. What I believe it is there's multiple levels, and each level is like a world, and that's a different sort of depth of ocean kind of thing. Okay, give me a minute to figure out how the UI works in this game, because I don't really know. No, I don't want that. I want the next item. There we go. I love so much about this game, but the UI is so bad. Right, is this going to work? I did a thing! Look, it's sticky, maybe. Okay, then we need... Like, why are you making me... It's fine. I like the game. I just don't like the UI. I'm allowed to not like everything. Bam! I did it!
That worked in keeping the pieces together, Marshall.
Woo!
I get the feeling there's more to this, though.
Woo!
Marshall, this isn't a sundial. It's a beacon.
Woo!
It's pointing to something.
I'll need to use another source of light while I go have a look.
Okay. So, I guess what we want to do is park the boat in front of the sundial. Beacon. So, if I keep this parked in front of it... Yeah, because you see when it's not facing it, it turns off. So, if we park this here... Make it nice and bright. See, that's pretty cool. The game's got so many good ideas. I just wish it was a little more polished in parts. Particularly the UI. I want to grab my little aquajet thing. What did I call the aquajet? What dramatic noise. Nah, 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 nah. Right, let's go. Kind of forgotten how to drive this thing. Woo! This is awesome. This is a great idea. Using the submarine to keep it lit, you know, that's clever. I like that. I'm kind of freaked out, though. Just because the game is perpetually scary. That looks like something I can...
Well, great. It's a rock. What am I supposed to do about that? We'll just sit. Unless I can detonate that cesium without blowing myself up as well.
Perhaps. Please be careful, Cerys.
Definitely about to die.
I'm always careful, Marshall.
I don't know if I have to stick it to it, or if I have to throw it, or what. Place cesium. Swim away fast. Okay. I did it. Where's my little boat? There it is. I didn't do it. I still have 3 pieces left. Okay. Maybe it's because I tried to swim away. Let's give this another go. Now I have to go back and get some oxygen.
Remember to move away after placing it.
Oh, I was trying to! Okay. Did it. That was quick! Jesus Christ! Oh no, my little boat! Come here.
Don't forget to refill your oxygen supplies by going back to your
seat. Yeah, I'm on it.
Marshall, I've uncovered a tunnel that leads further down. I'm going in.
Hold your horses, Cerys. This isn't a one-woman mission anymore. Let me assemble a team while you make your ascent.
Don't be ridiculous, Marshall. I have more than enough experience to handle whatever's down there.
Alright. But if you encounter anything you're unprepared for, anything at all, I will order you back to the surface.
Yes, sir.
I mean, she says that.
Good. Make sure your aquajet is securely docked in your cell before you proceed.
But... Oh, I'm gonna... Oh, right, okay, I'm gonna go down in the sub. Okay, so I don't need to do this. She says she's prepared. I got attacked by a mutant frickin' thing. A mutant, like, mermaid. I'm pretty sure her training didn't account for mutant mermaids with their face ripped off. I'm no underwater person. It's about the best I've got for that. But I'm pretty sure that isn't standard protocol. Wonder why I know. There's rocks in the way. Okay, this looks like a tight fit to me. Am I meant to go through here? Well, we're about to find out. It's okay. It's just a scratch. Oh god, are we actually going... Is this like the next part of the game? Are we just going deeper into the ocean? Oh, I don't like this.
What is going on?
I've lost control! Had to go on a one-woman mission, didn't you, Cerys?
What's going on here? Fuck.
I've got no control. I've got a little control. Okay, I was meant to do that, I guess. Stop swearing, Cerys. I'm a PG-13 channel. Whoa.
Phew. Oh my god. Marshall, my step suddenly shut down and I've sunk to the bottom. Marshall, come in. Can you hear me? Marshall? My radio's dead too. All systems cut off simultaneously. Must have been another EMP. I'm stranded here like the others. Okay. Calm down, Cerys. Calm down. You still breathing? Go inspect yourself.
I'm on it.
Marshall, I hope you can still hear me.
Okay, sub's dead.
I can recharge my oxygen for what's left in the sub. That's good. It won't last long, though. I'll need a new CO2 scrubber. The battery in my aquajet burned out. It won't come out of the sub at all. I'll need another battery. Need to fix the power supply on the sub as well. And the light emitter is shot too. Wonderful.
I need a lot, don't I? Bloody Nora.
Something's interfering with my visor interface. This can't be a normal EMP burst. It has to be something else. EMP signals mean machinery. Machinery means parts. Marshall! If I find the source of the disturbance, I might also find something to help me fix my sub and the radio. I hope you can hear me.
Okay. We're looking for the source of the disturbance. That's a big-ass shark right there. It's actually quite a small shark. Okay. Okay. Well, here we are, folks. Next kind of level, I guess you'd call it. Deeper in the ocean now, aren't we? We're gonna go this way. Towards the green things of happiness. Hopefully not die in the process. I'm definitely gonna die several times. It is creepier down here, I'm not gonna lie. It's a little creepier down here. It's just darker. You know, it's all a little bit darker. Also, I kind of feel naked without my sub. That blue thing... Oh, and the red thing. There's something big over here. You have to kind of make it there alive with no oxygen. What is that? What is that? Can you turn around, please? Thank you. Okay. Whoa. Oh, Nelly. I'm going to go for the nearest box and hope it's got oxygen in it. There's one there? Is that the one I'm looking at? What's that noise? Is that... Is that the shark or what is making that noise? It looks like extra... This is so annoyingly close and I'm pretty sure I'm not going to make it there alive. It's right there! Oh, that's so annoying. What a pitter. Okay. It's fine. This time I don't need to go faff around with... other stuff. I know it's not on top. We're gonna go left, we're gonna go for the white thing, whatever it is. Okay, we're gonna go back to this thing, grab the... Oh, they fixed this data log problem completely. Grab the data log again, and then the white thing I think is beyond that? I don't really know. Oh, right. I didn't read that last time. I got to imagine it is in this direction. The text is that direction as well, so it kind of like suggests it. I don't think I'd have to go over there. Also, I don't think there's any chests over there, which means, you know, you're going to die, basically. They're very nice colour, aren't they? Look at that. Okay. We're going to head straight for the sub. 1,000 metres below the surface. Are we going to head straight for the sub? Can we make it to the sub without dying? Probably. Yeah. I wish the sharks had some animation to them, I must say. Open your mouth, lad. Oh, no, no, down, down, not up, not up. I've done this before, it didn't end well last time, it's not going to end well again. Okay. I'm fine, though, I'm fine. Ah! Maybe that's the hint. When I look in a certain direction, the EMP fades, right? So maybe... the idea... is to look around and just head sort of towards the source, I think. There should be a... yeah, I'm going to go for this white thing because it is very close by. I don't actually know what it means. There should be a data log around here again. Yeah, I know it's there. Get out my way. Why is it in the way? What is that about? Seriously. Like, it's meant to guide me in the right direction, yet all it does is block me from seeing a bloody thing. Alright, the white thing's not a big deal, because whatever it is, it's right here. What is that? Ah! Right, I'm going back. I'm going back. The aquajet is wholly necessary to do this alive thing, because I want to go in that direction. That's where the source of the EMP was. Look, if we look over here, it fades. If we look over there, it gets stronger. So why is... upgrades? Bits? Important bits? What's blue? I'm sure blue's upgrades, but I can't find what that blue thing is. But anyways, we're going back to the boat. Another chest over here. Let's grab some oxygen just to make sure I don't die on the way back again. And I also didn't see these last time. Also, I want to read the data log. Shouldn't take all the oxygen. I'm gonna leave those ones there. Let's go! It's a really fun game when it gets out of its own way, if you know what I mean. It's kind of how it feels. The sharks are awesome, they just need more animation. But the model and design and just general creepy factor of them is through the absolute freaking roof. Not just the roof. The frickin' roof. Frickin'. Okay, right, there's the boat. We're gonna be fine. So I can probably actually sprint. Although I can't move this out for some reason. Zoom! Zoom! I can't sprint at all for some reason. What's going on? Have I broke my legs? Maybe it was a thing that I had on me that let me like power forward. Maybe. Maybe. Okay. You guys hear that? Anyways, refill. Lovely. Let's turn off the torch. Is the torch on? Give it off for a bit. We're very low on battery. And now, we hop on the old aquajet. Pshaw! I'm gonna get my move on. Why can't I release the aquajet? You told me I could release the aquajet! You literally said it would work now. What is that noise? I'm annoyed. Don't tell me I can do something and another. I assume. In order to actually access the aquajet, the access jet, that's not a thing, then I need to actually repair the whole sub. But I don't really see why. Oh well. We know where we're going. There's oxygen on the way. We're going to be hunky-dory putting goodbye. Maybe I should have been able to release it. I feel like I should have. I feel like they intended me to be able to release the aquajet there. But I was pressing C and it wasn't working. Oh well. There's oxygen here on the right, so we're going to grab this and then we're going to go in that direction. That's the source of the EMP. And what we're going to do is go from green to green to green. We're going to go from chest to chest to chest to try to keep our oxygen up. My worry is that we're going to die on the way back more than anything else, but... needs must. Where's my little... okay, there's two oxygens there. That's really good. Let's go! We're going to go to that next set of chests over there. You can just see the green blobs down this direction. That's our next destination. Because that is the source of the EMP. That direction there, if I had to guess. Yeah, definitely that direction. So the game wants me to go down here. Probably on an aquajet, admittedly. Alas. Poor Yorick. Chest isn't up there, is it? I feel like it might be up there. It's going to cause me some problems. No, there's one straight ahead anyway. As long as it's got oxygen in it, we're going to be hunky-dory pudding a pie. If it doesn't have oxygen in it, then we may be in a spot of bother, admittedly. What the hell? Ow! You cheeky little blighter! What are you doing? This is where I'm meant to be, I'm near the ground! I wasn't meant to get attacked down here. Go away! Where's this... I don't understand. I'm probably gonna die, so what I'm gonna do is use this time to explore. I feel like I should have seen a chest by now. Maybe we can hit that one in time, the one directly ahead of me. Optimistic, maybe, but... if we just keep going straight forward, maybe we'll have a bit of luck for once. It's up there, isn't it? Yeah. Just gotta swim up. Hope I don't drown, hope I don't get killed by a shark. Definitely both are going to happen to me right now. Up, 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 up. Oh, I'm definitely going to drown. I forgot to read the dialogue. Get out your tracker thing. I don't want to stop to get it out, but I need it now. Oh, I'm so dead. Just want to check something, yeah. I think what you have to do, maybe, after you get that first bit of oxygen, is swim up so you're on top of these rocks. Because that must be where the chests are, because I'm not seeing them anywhere else. It's a frustrating game, I'm not going to lie. Okay. I'm not convinced I'm willing to stick out for the whole thing, to be honest, guys. There's a lot about this game I love, but it feels like it needs like a few months of polish. It feels like it needs tightening up quite a lot. And I'm kind of going back and forth. I really want to see what happens. I want to get down into the depths and see all the dark, spooky things and stuff. But on the other hand, I don't want to battle against the game to have to get there. I'm tempted to maybe wait a few months, come back, let the game be fixed up a little bit. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what happens. We'll see how I feel in a couple of days. Thank you for joining me. Cheers. Much love. As always, not quite with goodbye. But we did get down. We got down into a new whole deepy spooky area. That's cool, right? That's a good thing. That's good. Yeah. Bye-bye.